Good morning, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Thank you for joining me. Early this morning, there in the Yukon territory, in Alaska, there was a magnitude 5.2 earthquake. 12:16 a.m. local time, and so far, 9 people have said they felt this earthquake. It actually was a little bit stronger. There is the spectrogram for the earthquake, and then there's the seismic signature. Yeah, we got volcanic and harmonic tremors. Interesting. It actually came in as a magnitude 5.44. And when I pulled the files, there was another earthquake afterwards, a small one. This one came in as a magnitude 2.43. And you can see it there at the bottom. The monitor that I'm using is Sagaway, Alaska. USGS said it was deep, 28.4 kilometers in depth for the 5.2, and they're claiming the 2.0, but it is stronger, was 28.7 kilometers in depth. So that would be 17.8 miles below sea level, and all earthquakes are measured at sea level. And then going to Google Earth, here we have Hubzu Peak in Mount Logan. And I want to bring this out. In 1979, there was a 7.2 near this location. And in 1899, an 8.0. This might bring up memories of the earthquake that occurred in 1964, the 9.2 earthquake. That one was very devastating. There is no tsunami warning for this earthquake, but there is a 20% chance it could be a foreshock for something much larger to come later. Originally, the 5.2 USGS said was a 5.3, but like I said, I get a 5.4 at least. The shaking lasted at least 2 minutes. That's what people would have felt during that time of the earthquake. But actually, it lasted longer. I don't know if I can bring it down to show you. There we go. So we got 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute, and it just kind of trails off. Here's that earthquake on the stream view. And I noticed at about 18:25 universal time, yeah, we had tectonic earthquakes going on, the movement of our plate. And there was one small earthquake. Let me pull it over. Right there. So I just pulled it just now, and I want to show you this bigger. Right there. I'm going to pull this over, and this comes in at about 10 hertz. Right there. And here's the signature for the 5.4. And it comes in, 10.4. And down here at the bottom, let me pull it over for you. Yeah, it's interesting. There's the spectrogram. A lot of gases came up. Mount Logan, it says here on Wikipedia, is the second highest peak in North America. After Denali, due to active tectonic uplifting, Mount Logan is still rising in height. And it's pretty well north of where this earthquake recently occurred. It is considered non-volcanic in origin, and it is considered the largest non-volcanic area circumferences in the area, or in the world, excuse me, in the world. Hard to believe when you see this type of activity that happened during this earthquake. I said there was tectonic activity going on several hours before this earthquake. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for taking your time to watch my videos, and thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.